Apple just wrapped up its September event announcing the new iPhones and new Apple Watches, and in this video, we're going to be taking a look at everything new with the new iPhones and Apple Watches, so let's get started. Jumping right into the video, we're going to start off with the Apple Watches, and let's begin with the Apple Watch Series 9. The Series 9 is getting a new system in processor, a new SIP, which is going to be the S9, which is finally getting an upgrade from the previous three models because the previous three models had the same chip, and it's finally getting a chip upgrade with an S9 chip in Series 9. The biggest new feature announced in the Series 9 because of the new S9 chip is double tap, where you can pretty much double tap your fingers and you can pretty much play pause music, answer calls, stop timers, and do a lot more by just simply double tapping your fingers. The Apple Watch Series 9 is also getting a new brighter display going up to 2000 nits, which means if you're in direct sunlight, you should be able to see what's going on your watch quite clearly. The Series 9 watch is also getting a new second generation ultra wideband, which is going to be a lot easier to locate your Apple Watch from your iPhone. And that's pretty much everything for the Series 9. Now, Apple also updated the Apple Watch Ultra with the Apple Watch Ultra 2, and it pretty much brings the same new features the Series 9 is going to be getting. So you're going to be getting the new S9 chip. You're also going to be getting the new double tap feature. The only biggest difference in the Apple Watch Ultra 2 is that it's going to be getting a brighter display at 3000 nits. Now let's talk about the iPhone. So Apple did announce the new iPhone 15 and iPhone 15 Plus, and like the rumor said, they are indeed getting Dynamic Island. So Dynamic Island is finally coming down to the baseline iPhone models. The iPhone 15 will be available in black, blue, green, yellow, and an all new pink color, and it's also going to be getting the frosted back that we've seen in the Pro models in previous years. The iPhone 15 and 15 Plus main cameras are going to be jumped up to 48 megapixel, so that means your images are going to be a lot more crisp, and portrait mode is going to look a lot better on the iPhone 15 and 15 Plus. There's also some chip upgrades for the iPhone 15 and 15 Plus, so they're going to be using the A16 Bionic, which is pretty much the same chip that was used in the iPhone 14 Pro and Pro Max last year, so the performance is going to be a lot better than the previous model. And like all the rumors were saying, the iPhone 15 lineup does get USB-C, but the iPhone 15 baseline model is capped at USB 2 speeds. And finally, for the star of the show, the iPhone 15 Pro and 15 Pro Max, there is a slight redesign on the 15 Pro and Pro Max, and they're going to be finally using a different material. So titanium is in fact actually true, and it looks really nice on the iPhone 15 Pro and Pro Max. The iPhone 15 Pro models will be using aerospace grade titanium, which is pretty much the same metals used in the Mars rover. Now that Apple is using titanium in the Pro models are going to be a lot more durable, and it's going to be a lot more lighter, which means it's the lightest Pro model iPhone ever. The performance on the iPhone 15 Pro is going to get a significant update. It's going to be running the A17 Pro chip, which is also going to be running on a 3-nanometer architecture, which is just insane. And it's also going to be using an all new Pro class GPU on the iPhone 15 Pro models, which is going to be just insane for the graphic performance on the iPhone 15 Pro and Pro Max. The iPhone 15 Pro models is also going to bring a significant camera update. So the all new 15 Pro and Pro Max will have a 48 megapixel main sensor, which can shoot at 24 millimeter, 28 millimeter, and 35 millimeters. On the ultra wide, you can shoot macro and 13 millimeter. On the telephoto lens, you can shoot 48 millimeters. And on the iPhone 15 Pro Max, you're going to be getting an all new 5x optical zoom, which means you can shoot at 120 millimeters. And like all the rumors were saying, the iPhone 15 Pro and Pro models are getting USB-C. However, the Pro models are getting the USB 3 speeds, which means you can transfer files 20 times faster than you could with Lightning. Now that the iPhone is using USB-C, reverse charging is finally possible, which means you can charge up your iPad, your Mac, and even your AirPods right from your iPhone through USB-C. The iPhone is also getting the second generation ultra wideband, so if you're sharing your location with your friends, it's going to be a lot easier to find your friends nearby. And it's going to be also a lot easier to find your Apple Watch if you have the Series 9. And finally, let's talk about the prices. So the Apple Watches are staying the same pretty much. They have the same prices. The iPhone 15 is going to stay the same as well. The 15 Pro is going to be the same. The only price increase is going to be for the 15 Pro Max, which is starting at $1,199, but it's also a 256 gigabyte model. So there is no 120 gigabyte for the 15 Pro Max. Only for the 15 Pro and the iPhone 15 models. And that's pretty much everything Apple covered at the event today. I definitely will be getting the iPhone 15 Pro Max, so make sure you're subscribed to see coverage of that. And if you guys like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.